According to the Minister for Housing, it is never an easy task to evict people when they have already established themselves and are comfortable. But the minister says he will do whatever he has to.
As a government, I will tell you that we are always prepared to do what is necessary in the interest of the people and communities. One, from an urban renewal point of view, and secondly, from a social point of view. And if it is that we have to relocate or dislocate the persons in the area, along with the other partners, we will do what we have to do.
However, residents of the Hospital Road Cemetery say they feel bad about the plan the government has for them, especially in the view of the length of time they have been living there.
I have been living here from time I was 9 years old. Right now I'm 34 years of age, and that's why I have three children, and my three children is around here they born.
Okay. The authorities want to take people out of here. What is your take on that?
My take on that, nobody never come and tell us, well, they want to take out people here. We never see nobody, nothing about that. We don't know nothing about that.
If they have to take you out, what are your concerns about that?
Our concern is, my concern and people in the area, is what they're going to do for us. Because after so much years, there are people that live in here longer than my family. And after so much years, what they're going to tell us, what they're doing for us, that's what we want to know.
Florence James is 85 years old, and she says that it's 33 years since she's been living in this cemetery. The senior citizen feels that at her age, it would be an inconvenience for her to relocate.
I feel very bad because to see to leave and to go somewhere far and everything. And at my age, I'm not working to go. Probably I might have to pay transport every day, and I'm not working. I am not married, I don't have no husband.
I done dead already. I dead already.
Yes.
I don't feed myself, nobody feeding me. Government give me only 150 a month. That ain't lasting a week. I have to buy pampers, you see, right now I don't pump. I have to buy pampers with that money. Yeah? I have to buy food. Time for the month to end. I said 150, I have to beg somebody, give me a dollar, give me something. So, you know, bro, so you take me out from close tongue, so it's ready. I dead already, kill me.
One resident says that he thinks that this is discrimination against both the living and the dead. He says it was the government that built steps and footpaths for them, and later Wasco and Lucilec provided water and electricity.
There's that cross at the back of me there, and the bishop and them made them move the remains of the old bones of the priest and them that was there. So what we want to know, it's not when we come in that, but when they're going to be removing the other bodies that's there, right? Because right now, if the priest remains is more important than the other bodies that are there, right? We have been living there for so long. Even go see the tombs and the things that there is our family.
The Minister for Housing says that due to financial limitations and constraints, he is unsure as to the extent of the assistance that the government can give to the residents. Nevertheless, the minister says the package will obviously involve some land, but he made it clear that the land would not be given away freely, but will be offered at a subsidized rate. For the DPS News World, Alex Buske reporting.